What's up, toy fans? This is M, back again with Triple M's Toy Palace. Hey, you guys remember last time when I said that I probably wasn't going to talk about any more Kamen Rider toys in the next episode? Maybe? Well, I lied. Another fine product of Bandai and the Smart Brain Corporation, intended to complement the complete selection modification Fize gear from our previous episode. This, still sealed in its shipping crate, is the complete selection modification Fize XL. I don't know what this shit is. I think they have some crappy catalog that they paste or stick on the box, then somebody rips it off and it fucks up the box. The other CSM box I have has that too. So, you know, for once, customs didn't really fuck with my stuff, so it's still totally sealed up with tape and we're gonna have to cut it open here. Let's use this to cut it open. This knife is ultra sharp. It kicks ass pretty hard. I'll fucking cut you. Check it out. Just like its bigger brother, here it is wrapped up in a little tissue paper in a Smart Brain box. Let's take a closer look. Here is the box and its slipcase, following in the same traditional style as the other complete selection modification releases, and in tune with the Fize gear box featuring Fize's startup phase on one side and time out on the other. Let's open it up and take a look inside. Here it is taken out of the box. There's the Fize XL time-stopping watch, the XL's mission memory chip, and the manual, which, again, is going to be in English, which is super rad. I'm gonna need to get out the Fize belt for this, so let's go ahead and do that now, I guess. Why does it do it twice in two different ways? Why? Flip the switch on the back near the watch to turn it on and make the classic Fize sound. Okay, now that I've got the belt set back up, we can put the fucking watch on. Let's see what's going on here. I tell you, everybody, I'm right-handed, and a weird thing about me is that I always wear a watch on my right hand, so doing this left-handed shit. I know you're supposed to wear your watch on your left hand, that's what fashion dictates or whatever, but dude, this is like the weirdest, hardest thing to put on. Oh, there it goes. Then you do this. Don't scratch your watch up. Shit ain't cheap. Let's take a look there. Oh, look at this, huh? Kind of flips around in your wrist there again. Look at that there, you know? Okay. Wow, holy shit. So, just take this thing back. Like the other items in Fize's arsenal, the XL brace masquerades as an ordinary waterproof digital watch, but actually generates a accelerating tachyon field, which makes 5 seconds appear to go like 50 to the wearer. That means you can punch a lot of dudes really fast, spend a lot of money on special effects in a short amount of time. Let's observe the features up close and personal here. We've got the mission memory plugged in. The digital watch part doesn't actually work. It just says it's always 5:55 o'clock in 55 seconds. I'm totally okay with this. And then we have the action button to start the Excel phase. And this is a new option button, which plays two really cool sound bites that we'll take a look at. Just like in the last episode, we'll need to gently yet firmly pull out our mission memory from the Excel brace, like so. It's always a little disappointing when that happens, isn't it? Here is the regular Fize and the Fize XL mission memory side by side, just to illustrate the differences in colors and detailing, which are indicative of how his armor looks when transformed into either state. I'm a fully grown man, and I play with toys all night long, you heard me. Then, just as gently yet firmly, click the mission memory into the phone as seen here, where it does absolutely nothing. This is total bullshit because, as we can clearly see in the English manual, the belt recognizes the mission memory and will say the appropriate things when you fuck around with it, but I think I've got serious problems with the belt. It doesn't recognize the phone correctly and it doesn't do anything when I plug the chip in, which totally sucks. I can't exactly just call someone up at Smart Brain and get another one sent out. Nor is it really worth the postage to do so and I'm an American import customer, so I'm kind of fucked anyway, but at least the manual's in English. Well, good thing I got the belt out, right? I guess let's go take a look at the rest of what the watch does. Alright, even if the belt doesn't really behave, the watch still does. There's a button on the top and one on the bottom. The one on the bottom is the really important one, but the one on the top is cooler.
Start up.
Some more high quality sound and light effects. The speaker is right next to the watch and that grill there, so it sounds good, and I really like the trailing LED light effects, true to the show, as usual. I think the new top button is my favorite. This feature was not available on the DX version. Check it out. YouTube better not fucking flag me for this. The watch plays two of the songs from Fize, People With No Name. It also plays Fize's theme song, Justifies. And what's even cooler is this. Check it out.
Start up.
Dude, how hard is that? If that does not give you a giant Fize boner, I don't know what the fuck will. That's pretty amazing. It's like fucking hit clips of the two Fize singles. No, hit clips. What was the other one? Maybe it was. That was the cassette tape one too, right? Oh shit, what was that called? Now I'm gonna be here all night, I tell you guys. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the Fize XL Brace. Looks cool, sounds cool, may or may not work with your belt depending on if you got a dud or not. As usual, the build quality is high, the detailing is just like the show. I really enjoy having the two sound clips as well as being able to mix them with the actual XL speeding up sound effect. Definitely a badass item. If it really does work with your belt. I mean, I'm in America, so there's like 14,000 other Indonesians who have spoiled this toy already and released videos that actually have viewers, so maybe watch one of theirs, or I'll check it out and see if they work or not. But anyway, this was all just the preamble to tonight's main event, Triple M's Snacks Palace. I'm Triple M, and this is my Snacks Palace. Usually when I get toys sent to me from Japan, I pay a little extra and I have a bunch of cool snacks sent to me. In the last episode, I took a look at a few of them, but what usually happens is I shoot a couple of the snacks and I say, oh yeah, I'm gonna save the rest of these and I'll eat them and show them off at the end of future episodes of the Toy Palace, but I just eat them all, you know, that week while playing video games. So, today, we're going through the whole damn box. I'm gonna open up each and every one of these snacks, and we're gonna eat them, starting with this. Okay, check this out. This is kabayaki, which is either catfish or eel teriyaki, pretty much. I can't tell which one this is, but we're gonna eat it. Okay, so. Oh, it kind of looks like a rice cracker. Check out that. Smells like teriyaki. I'm totally one of those dudes that just eats shit on YouTube now. Check it out. Okay, let's try this. Wow, that smells really good, just like soy sauce. Yeah, it's cool. Oh, yeah. It's just like an American would say, hey, that's really sweet tasting teriyaki beef jerky you got there. But I think I'm actually eating an eel, which is kind of weird. It's good though. Well, that one was eely good. Get it? Eely good, huh? No? All right, well, We're gonna eat this one next. I was pretty stoked when I saw this. I was like, oh, sweet, pizza sticks, because it looked all pizza. And then I zoomed in and I was like, oh, the dreaded vegetables. So they're gonna be vegetable sticks from Calbee, but these are totally good. I'm pretty sure I really did get the pizza ones last time, but you know, let's try this one out. Go ahead and get these open here. Oops. I hate it when I fuck up the peel. It's supposed to have a nice firm peel. Don't fuck your peel. Oh yeah, remember, they're like jerky fried onions that you have at strangers' houses on Thanksgiving dinner. I don't serve that shit personally. Okay. Let's try this out. Can I focus on that a little bit? Now? It's only a $700 phone camera. Well, let's eat this. Huh. They're fine. Wow, they taste exactly like old Jack-in-the-Box French fries. I better stop eating these. I think this says brown sugar, and this is gonna be some sort of churro. You know, a Japanese churro. You guys remember the old school 80s Maruchan cup noodles commercial where the white dude took his kids to the baseball game and it turned into that crazy animated samurai baseball thing? I'm not really sure if that's a cool commercial or if that's just totally racist. There's a piece broken off on the top. I can't pull it out of the bag. That's how you fix that. We're on TV, folks. Oh, is this a... I actually think this is a shrimp puff that has brown sugar on it. It smells like soy sauce. What the fuck is this thing? Huh. Yeah, it's just like a... It's like a coffee cake tasting thing. It's really savory. It's kind of sweet, but it's got like a burnt coffee taste, like coffee candy. That's not bad. Check this out. This is a kit. I think I have to add milk and water or something to this and make it later, but it's strawberry dessert curry. This will be happening in a future episode, or I might just make it on my own and then talk about how great it was. Everybody already knows that Pocky is great, so we'll just talk about these flavors for a second. This one is orange peel and chocolate, which you see here in the States around holiday times. You already know what that tastes like and you know it's gonna be good. And this is, I think, simple straight up vanilla Pocky, vanilla cream Pocky, which you also already know what tastes like and is obviously going to be good. I personally don't drink too much cola or sugary stuff myself, but I do like the flavor, so when I see it, I definitely try to enjoy it. So when I saw this mini cola come out of the package, I was pretty stoked. This has got some really old school Coke type packaging too. We're gonna have to, I think you pop the top to open it up. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, it's time to get your top popped up in here. You guys ever had to pop your own top poppers? Oh yeah, popped it so hard. Oh, it's the powdery type. That's pretty old school. I bet these are good. They look like pills. Hey kids, you wanna take my drugs? Yeah, these taste like flat Walmart brand cola. They kinda get better. You know these are going to be good. This is from Meiji, and they are strawberry bonbons with a brandy chocolate filling, and it's got some brandy there. Here's the box opened up, and it presents you with a couple nice little bonbons wrapped up in some nice strawberry bonbons. Oh yeah, check that out. Total bonbons. everybody knows that umeboshi candy, sweet umeboshi, is pretty much my favorite Japanese candy flavor. Here is another big bag of hard umeboshi candies. I have not had this assortment yet, and we're gonna do these. This is Morinaga Haichu, and this is also umeboshi, but it's the fresh plum flavor before they are pickled. I haven't had these yet, so let's go ahead and open these up and give them a look-a-rooski. Here's one opened up and ready to go. Let's pop it in my hot young mouth and see how it tastes. It's still umeboshi, but so smooth. So firm. Man, that's good. This is the piece de resistance. I hear that this particular item is already gaining notoriety on the internet. This is the Country Mam brand gourmet cream stew cookies. Get in there. The cookies are filled with cream stew. And you've got some nice mushroom and I think potato and broccoli and a carrot, and I think there's like a weird protein thing there, and it's in a cream stew, and they made a cookie out of this, and now I have to eat this, so we're gonna be doing that now. Oh, they're individually wrapped. Just looks like a cookie. And smell this. Oh. Oh, it's not bad. It's just really strong. I mean, it's a cookie, but it smells like a fucking turkey pot pie. Oh, let's break this open. Oh my god. What the fuck? What the fuck? Oh, that has a carrot, and this has a piece of potato stuck in it. Wow. Okay, let's eat this potato part. Oh my god. Ugh. 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 Oh, that's so terrible. Oh, what the hell? Oh. 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 God. Oh. Fuck me. Oh. It's so gross. It's not gonna make you gag or anything, but the cookie has like a white chocolate type base combined with chicken gravy, and then it's got this full-on savory middle of poultry gravy and veg, and then if you are lucky enough to hit one of these delightful bits inside. Oh, God. Oh. The flavor lingers as well. Oh. Maybe I can vape it out. Jesus. Oh, man. That's rough. Well, ladies and dudes, what can I say? That's pretty much it. The XL watch is pretty cool. The belt is not cooperating. Don't really understand. The snacks were totally decent, and the cream stew cookies are fucking disgusting. I'm Triple M, and this has been my Snacks Palace. See you next time.
Coming soon to the palace.